eager to see this book. That is in Tamil, is it? And you translated the title. Maybe now we need one in English for the Mumbaikars. Okay? He is basically a Mumbaikar, but he left Mumbai long ago. And he has traveled far and wide. He has been to Australia, South Africa, then Malaysia. He had a long stay, about 8 to 9 years, where again he was, or 4 years, where he was president again over there of the mission. And he has also been to Thailand, Hong Kong, and Bangladesh. So you can see how varied his experiences must have been when he visited these places and also gave talks. Another wonderful thing he did was he held a conference in Kerala on Ramakrishna Paramahansa and Vivekananda Bhaktas. That was the theme of that conference. And I think that must have been a first as well, to have this kind of movement where both these great sages were discussed in this conference. And devotion, of course, must have been evoked about the same. He has been talking about various spiritual matters. He has given talks on value education and also on personality development. That is his varied domain. And he has spoken in schools, colleges, then Lions clubs, Rotary clubs. All these people have been inviting him over. So you can see now how specially privileged we are to have him among us. And some faculty of Ruya are also present, and some students. They are not many in number, but they are really seekers in the making, and I'm sure they will love to talk to you now and listen to you. Okay? There are some science students as well among the audience. So thank you so much, and I invite you to take over. Thank you.
Seventeen youngsters are here, including him, 18. Do numbers make anything in life? No. No or yes? Don't be afraid. Just about 40 years before, I was also a student like you in the M.L. Dhanukar College. We used to go to NM College for our NCC camps on Sunday. We'll be having few minutes of relaxation in a friendly journey into our own life. So don't feel much rigid or much of a frozen feeling. You can be in a good joyful feeling. We are not sitting in the classroom, nor are we going to have any exams. So the simple question, does number make any sense? Yes or no? Because she told Swamiji there are hardly 18 or 25 members we have. Number makes any difference? Sometimes yes, sometimes no. We find in the life that Pandavas were only 5 in numbers. And Kauravas, there were hundreds along with the vast army. And it was the dilemma for Arjuna and Duryodhana. What will you choose, quantity or quality? Nani Palkhivala, have you heard of his name? He was a great legal luminary. When he visited Japan, he asked one of the ministers, "Sir, two atomic bombs have been dropped on Japan. You are progressing so fast. Nothing was dropped on India. And after freedom, you have got a huge population. How is it you are developing so fast and we could not?" The minister just smiled, put one of his hands on the shoulders of the great legal luminary, Nani Palkiwala, and told, "Sir, you have population, we have citizens." So quality makes population transform into a citizen. Few citizens can set the whole country on fire. So revolution or kranti doesn't come through crowds. Viplav ek vyakti ke dwara aata hai, bheed se kabhi nahi. That we have to understand. Revolution starts with a single man. Cancer cell doesn't start at a time with 100 cancer cells. One first comes, enters your body, one virus. Now the question is, if that one can be you, can you cause revolution in this world? Yes, no? That is a beautiful answer, you see. The possibility is opened with the affirmation of the thought. Yes. Now the probability will vary. The situation, the scenery, and hundreds of things. But there is a possibility that you can cause a revolution, is it not? So as you look at the world, you will find each one of us, each one individually, we have got that potentiality to cause a revolution inside oneself as well as in the world outside. If one dacoit, Ratnakar, can become Valmiki, is it not? So one man changing, will it cause any effect in this world? Normally we put the question, is it not? Whenever I attend the meeting on anti-corruption, other thing, "Swamiji, you are a Swamiji, you don't have to go and run behind the world." But they don't know that we also have to meet the municipality officers, the government officials and others. So when you change, will the world change? That's a very potential question and very explosive question. And as you look at the history of the world, you will find that always one man changing, one Karl Marx, one Lenin, one Buddha, one Jesus, one Krishna, one Vivekananda, one Anna Hazare. So revolution never comes in crowds. That is the point. Revolution, viplav, ek vyakti ke dwara aata hai. And it can be any one of us. But moment you say, "I am an ordinary man," you have closed the door for heaven. Moment you say, "Yes, it is possible." It may be 10 years, 20 years, 50 years. But possibility keeps the door open. So breeze can come anytime inside. But if you close the doors of the windows, breeze cannot enter. So each one of you feel that there is some uniqueness, some place for you in this universe. Every nut, every bolt, every washer also has a place in any particular instrument. Sometimes an ordinary washer can create problem, you know. Have you seen the wash basin taps? Just the washer goes out. "No, ye to washer chota hai na, iska kya hai? Main to Amrita hoon, main to ek pitaji to yahan kuch kaam karte hain. Main kya kuch kranti ya viplav aisa kya kar sakti hoon main to? I am an ordinary, insignificant person." That is one of the great bane we have. In ancient days when youngsters went, they were given the first thing, "You are that. Tattvamasi." By Tattvamasi, they gave the idea that you are that supreme consciousness. Supreme consciousness means you are the greatest Now you see, spirituality you don't like, is it not? You like. Of course, nowadays the new trend among the youngsters is that they have started liking the spirituality, because we think spirituality, Vibhuti, Babaji, of course so many other humbugs are going on. Real spirituality is make you fill with infinite strength, courage. Make you ready to take the battle of life. That's why in Bhagavad Gita, you don't find Sri Krishna asking you to go to Santoshima, go to Titwale, Lalita Sahasranam Pado. Arey Arjun, utho! What a message. Manliness. That is a call of Gita and all our scriptures. And in the society, another bane you find is whenever youngsters come, we always underestimate them, is it not? Ye to bachcha hai. You go and tell your mother, mommy, elder sister's marriage, I will make all the arrangements. Tu baith ab. Bachchi ho, tu kya samajhti? So everywhere they want, that's what we see in the Indian context. 8 years old, still he wants to be the prime minister. 70 years old, budhiya ho gayi hai, phir bhi chhodti nahi. Are, jawan ladke log, ye log kya karenge? The whole energy is bubbling, intelligence, courage, enthusiasm, enterprising nature. Baitho na. Nahi, I'm just telling. But in the last century, one great man rose. One single man put the map of India in the world map with such honor and such prestige that the whole world turned to India. There he says, India is the cradle of my infancy, the pleasure garden of my youth, the sacred heaven Varanasi of my old age. I am proud to call myself an Indian. Indians proudly proclaim with the voice of thousand thunders that you are proud to be an Indian. Those days when we were slave, Vivekananda stood on the western platform and thundered that I am proud to call myself an Indian. So how much of gut feeling, that self-confidence, Atma Samman. Do you feel you are important? And don't look at her. You see, in life you cannot copy, you know. Examination you can copy. Life cannot be copied. Challenges and the response cannot be copied. But if you pay value for yourself, then the value increases. So in the last century, as Swamiji put India on the world map, and as he came back to India, he made one prophetic utterance. With that we are starting the session. My faith is in the younger generation, the modern generation. Out of them will come workers who will solve the problems of India like lions. How beautiful, is it not? My faith is in the younger generation, the modern generation. Subhash Chandra Bose, he came to join Ramakrishna but to become a sannyasi. And our Swami told, no, your field is somewhere else. Go and sacrifice for the country. Narendra Modi came to join our Rajkot Ramakrishna Mutt. Ramakrishna Mutt told, no. When he was 17. So his faith in the modern generation, the younger generation, they came, Chandrasekhar Azad, Veer Savarkar. Sitting in the jail, Veer Savarkar used to read Vivekananda's Song of the Sannyasin. He translated it into Marathi. And he used to meditate here, reading Swami Vivekananda's Raja Yoga. And he writes, after the whole day's exhaustion and terrible pain in the body, when I used to sit and focus on the brow, middle of the brow, according to Vivekananda's teachings, I used to be getting an experience of drowning myself in infinite sea of bliss, and all the bodily pains and aches will disappear. Have you seen Veer Savarkar's movie? No. It has been sponsored by Sudhir Phadke. Have you heard the name of Sudhir Phadke? Ye kya bhai sanyasi hum jante, tum log nahi jante ho. I have seen Veer Savarkar's movie 3 times. Fantastic, inspiring, you see. Young boy at the age of 19. What daredevil, you see. That's a pride of Maharashtra. Don't go into the political circle. Some may not like Veer Savarkar. But a young boy at the age of 19, he says, Janma Bhumi ke liye, Maa ke liye, mai kuch karna chahta hoon. And everybody is so selfish. He says, I want to do something for India's. Then he goes to London and the different experiences he has, lovely. Whatever may be the different colorings the political parties are giving, but the ability to sacrifice for others, dusron ke liye, can you do something? So how much vast the personality must be. So with this quotation of Swamiji, that my faith is in the younger generation, the modern generation. Out of them will come my workers who will solve the problems of India like lion. You wait for another 20 to 50 years. Indian population is getting 75% of our population is of youngsters, is it not? And another 20, 30 years, the old regime is out. These youngsters will throw the whole world into convulsions. So much of development, so much of fear is there in the other countries that this explosive energy of Indians, what it cannot do. India has a magic of its own, is it not? It can do anything. Anytime down under, India is thunder, is it not? When we were in Dhanakar College, we used to see the one-day matches. And they used to show the board, down under, India thunder. So that much of energy, faith, confidence and self-esteem, Swami Vivekananda pumps into the youngsters. Regain this confidence that I too can do something. I need not be a blazing sun. Even as a night lamp, I can shed light. Is it not? What can you give? So namaskars to all the youngsters who are gathered here. Wishing you all the best. We will start with one story which will be again surrounding this particular theme. Can one man, because this one man is more important, each one of us. One day evening as the sun was about to set on the western horizon, he was gripped with a worry that who will give light to this universe if I sit down? Is jagat ko kaun roshni dega mere astaman ke baad? So he loudly shouted, who will give light to this universe if I go down? And down the valleys where there were hundreds of huts, there was great silence. Nobody answered. He asked second time because his duty time was getting over. Second time also there was no sound, no reply, no answer, no response. Third time again he shouted, who will give light to this universe? And from the valleys it echoed, light, 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 light. And he found there is no response. And as he was about to sit down with great worry and burden in the heart, suddenly he heard a feeble voice, my Dunga. Then he came out and saw a 80-year-old lady had lighted a small mud lamp. And from the small flame, the voice came, I will give light, I will give light. Salaam Alaikum. And the sun set down. And there was darkness all around the valley. And the hut of the old lady where she lighted that small mud lamp was full of brightness. And all the other villagers, they came bringing their own lamps. And one by one they lit their own lamps and went back to their houses. And within few minutes the entire valley was full of light. So who gave light? My. Every one of us can give light. It is one single lamp which we light during the Deepavali. Ek saath mein hajaron deep nahi jalti hai. Ek ek karke. So pahla deep. Can you be that first lamp? So that is a question, and once you say, yes, I can be. And that small lamp was not a hydro, this, what do you call, what light we have got on the roads? Suddenly I am missing the sodium A problem. It's just a small flame, but yet it has the capacity to give light, is it not? And one spark has the potency to create a conflagration, is it not? And within few minutes you found that whole valley was lighted up. That's how in long time before Vande Mataram Mangal Pandey shouted, is it not? At that time if you had thought, mai akela Mangal Pandey kya kar sakta hu? Jo kar sakte ho karo. Mai akela ek bindu mein sindhu samaya hai, hai na? In small drop the whole ocean is contained, is it not? If you want to study the ocean, you don't take the whole ocean to your lab, is it not? When you want to have a blood test, do they suck all the blood from you? A drop of blood is enough to tell what is the constancy of your blood. So in each drop, you have the ocean. In you, the whole universe is there. This concept we must get clear into our brain. Then we will find that things are opening up psychologically inside, and we find there is a way, yes, I need not be a sodium vapor light, but within my capacity, within my small area, as Mr. Joshi told, what are you doing? Within our area, what can we do that we do? Is it not? So with namaskarams to all the elders and every one of you present here, we enter in the subject. So doing, what is today's theme? What is today's theme? Aaj ka kya subject hai? How many of you are having stress? You are having? Really or just for the sake of... Madam, you are having stress. Or are you trying to stress that? Is it because we stress too much on stress that it is becoming a problem? You are having? Most of us may not be having. And once the stress becomes a fashion, no. You would like to wear it, is it not? Whether we like it or not, we all follow the fashion. Usko stress hai, mujhe bhi stress chahiye. Neither we are not up to the mark, is it not? So in the very first point, we'll come to the theme of the today's discussion. That one point itself is sufficient for you. Stress, what is the theme of today's subject? That's actually, if you see stress management, it's totally a wrong connotation. You cannot manage stress. Why? Why you can't manage stress? Is stress real? Somebody else had stress, is it not? Who else had? Is stress real? A reality? Is it so? Yes or no? Perception of? No, is stress real? Yes. So if stress is real, you can do something to it. Shadow is real or not? Can you do anything to the shadow? Because it has no existence. You may see a shadow, but by itself, shadow has no existence. Switch off the light, shadow is out. Remove the object, shadow is out. So the shadow depends on two things for its real existence. One is the light and another is the object. Remove the light and the object, you will find there is no real existence of the shadow. Similarly, stress also doesn't have a real existence. That is why in the same battlefield of Kurukshetra, how many people were standing? Who had stress? In the Kurukshetra warfare, who had stress? Arjuna alone had. Why? If it were real, everybody would have felt it, is it not? The sun is real, all of us feel the heat. Though stress is a relative thing. What is relative cannot be an absolute thing. So it doesn't have a real full existence. This is one point. You have to understand that this stress is therefore not in the thing itself. It is not in the world itself. It is not in the situation itself or in the scenery. Kashmir, It is a land, paradise on earth, is it not? But what is the situation? It is a hell now, is it not? So scenery is God made, situation is individual made. You make the situation. So what is required is, don't try to manage the stress. More and more you try to manage the stress, stress says, wah, kya rubab hai mera. He is giving so much of importance to me, and in that very thing charbi chad jata hai stress ka. You make stress so much alive, so much real. What is more important is not stress, you. Your whole attention is going there. Stress ko pakdo, stress ko manage karo. Oh, bola, wah, abhi maja aa raha hai. Log sab mujhe dekh rahe hain. Abhi my speaker, baki sab audience ban gaye. So I have taken the spotlight, the limelight. Yet, in spite of all these things, to that single man who is experiencing the stress, it seems to be a matter of actuality, is it not? At that time. Now we'll again little more deeply, what exactly is stress now? Because if we want to manage this madam, suppose we are all belonging to BI, Bureau of Intelligence, I want to manage this madam. We have got reports that she is in connection with PAC intelligence agencies. Don't take it seriously. Now what should I know? To manage her, I have to gather all the information about her, is it not? Keep a track of her movements, her phone calls, her activities. So totally I have to keep her under my scanner, is it not? She is under scanner and observation. Have you observed stress any time? No. That means you are not bothered about stress. Or it is not really stressful for you to take your attention there. Perhaps you don't have stress at all. Because I put the question, class mein kisi ne haath uncha nahi kiya, maine haath uncha kar diya. Is it so? So when you have stress, why did you not attend to it? Why? Have you attended the stress any time? Now, did you observe the stress? Because you have to gather knowledge. If I want to manage my motorbike, I must gather all the knowledge. Or I have to give to the garage. Tum dekh lo bhai, theek karke de do. Is it not? Sometimes he creates more problem also. If you go to Chor Bazar, he may add more new problems. So now you see, why you did not attend on the stress? It is troubling you, it is creating some sort of damage for you. It has been a nuisance for you, is it not? One mosquito comes, we bite it, simply hit it, na, throw it out, remove it, machar ko nikalo. So why you didn't do anything on that? What stopped you? Deviated towards? So other things are occupying your disk space so much that you have no time to allot. Stress. Free from stress. Come this side. This is more easy to go out. You want to leave, na? Come, come this side. Oh, entrance is that side. There is an entrance. Oh, achha, okay. You can walk, no problem. Please come, be free. We are having a light, refreshing session just to release our mind. So now two examples, case studies. So I am not quoting any scriptures, Bhagavad Gita, this or that. Usko sab chhod denge. We'll come directly to the actuality. You have stress. You use the word stress. What exactly it is? Because if you don't have knowledge, knowledge is power. Everywhere. Knowledge gives you power. Otherwise, you have to depend on somebody else. Like you have got your laptop, you know how to format it. And whenever there is a problem, you know how to repair it, is it not? Otherwise, you have to wait for the technician to come and get it repaired. So are you going to wait for the technician? In the external world, it may be necessary. But in the internal world, in the field of your psychological existence, whole thing is created by you, because it is your own exclusive individual feeling, is it not? So who can more easily operate? Who is more near and dear to that problem of yours? Except you. So why did you not attend? That is one of the important. That is why we are not able to manage the stress, because we don't bother about it. Simply in the mind thinking that stress management doesn't manage the stress. A donkey thinking my share, who my share can, who doesn't make it a share. Because we are combining two big topics today. One is being calmly active and stress management. So in the stress management, all of you are having stress. One, two, how many others are having stress? Huh? Bachi, small girl, you are having stress. Okay, we'll come back to that individual cases, because every case has to be dealt individually depending on its merits. So stress, actually, either we are making it up or a wrong conception about a thing also can cause stress. In general, when the flow of action, our life is full of action, is it not? Life means action. Any organism, if there is no action, it is dead. Even a single cell in your body, if it is not acting, that means it is declared dead. Dead cells are there in your body. So life means action. According to Vivekananda, spirituality means action. So what happens to us is, most of us gathers information because it is easily available. Yesterday one boy came, he has got a lot of stress. It is artificial stress. He has created the stress. The simple problem is, he has already saath fera karne ke baad, ek ladki hai ghar mein, uski patni. अब उसका नजर दूसरे एक लड़की के ऊपर जा रहा है. तब तो मुझे घर में नहीं, इतना स्ट्रेस है. मतलब घर में नहीं, तुम्हारे दिमाग में है स्ट्रेस. आइए मैडम, स्ट्रेस इज नॉट इन योर वाइफ, नॉट इन योर हाउस, इट इज इन योर माइंड. आफ्टर 7 फेरा अग्निसाक्षी देने के बाद, व्हाई डू यू लुक एट अनदर गर्ल? व्हाई? सो यू हैव क्रिएटेड an obstacle to the free flow of action. Action, when it flows freely, you will not find anything inside you. The flow, when it gets a bottleneck, or when it is clogged, or when it gets an obstacle, like what happens in our body, when the flow of blood is stopped or affected, what do you call that? When the blood flow is affected, what do you call? Blood clot, so many blocks, everything, then you do bypass surgery or thinning the clot. So in our life also, when we are able to go through the action, both mentally as well as physically. Action means you have mental action. Suppose if your thought current is also meeting an obstacle, or if there is an impediment to your mental functioning, then you will find a stress. Similarly, physically also. Suppose you want to go out and there's a curfew. You want to go out, suddenly there has been a heavy downpour. It will take 5 hours to reach from here to Vadala. Oh my God, it creates a stress. Once the floods or the rainwater recedes, what will happen? The traffic becomes clear and you flow, wow, now it's relaxing. So the stress is created because the energy flow through action. Chinta man mein aur bahar, apne sharir ke dwara, karma. Ye dono sthiti mein hum jab badha anubhav karte hain, us waqt is stress ka mehsoos ho raha hai. Badha nikal dene se pravah apne aap chalta hai. Now don't refer to any books. Don't refer to any gods. No prophets. No messengers. Because you are so great, so unique, that you have the problem and the very problem contains the answer. Can you attend the problem? You'll find most of the medicines invented for disease, they have not come outside of the disease. It is from the disease itself the medicine is coming out. The difficulty with us is that whenever a problem comes, what we do? Madam, when you get a problem, what you do? Don't create a problem by asking this question. Huh? Suppose if nobody is there. Yes, that means you have given your attention to the problem. Now, this is a problem. How to come out of it? What we do, you know, most of the time, we simply avoid the problem, run away from the problem. The stress is so frightening. It is not the stress that is frightening. It is fear that is frightening. Fear is one of the most frightening thing in the world. Vivekananda's message, he says, spirituality is fearlessness. What a beautiful saying, is it not? Moment you are afraid, you are nobody. Fearlessness brings benediction this moment. That's why when Janaka Raja, you know Janaka Raja? You know Janak Sita ki Pitaji. Oof. All so many things you know about Shah Rukh Khan and Amitabh, but our own history, Sita Maiya, Mithila, ke jo Raja te, Janak, Janakanandini, Sita's name. When he was given knowledge by the sage Ashtavakra, he told Abhayam vai praptosi Janakaha, Janakaha, ya God Abhaya, fearlessness. So our Indian spirituality does not tell anything to you. Spirituality means fearlessness of right kind. So why are we afraid of meeting stress? Tell me now, very quickly we have to go because time is very short. वैसे दिस आर ऑल क्लिनिकल थीम्स वेयर जैट फटफट करके ऐसा कुछ किया और भाग्य नहीं होता है. जिंदगी इतना आसान नहीं है. इट्स लिविंग वेरी फ्लूइड. यू सी हॉट गरम गरम बटाटा वड़ा है ये. बाद में जाने के बाद घर में मैं चिंता करूंगा उसके बारे में नहीं. दैट इज इमेजिनरी थिंग. भांसी बटाटा वड़ा उसको कोई नहीं खाते. व्हेन वी आर डिस्कसिंग व्हेन द स्ट्रेस कम्स अप वेयर इट कम्स अप वेयर where the stress is felt somewhere inside. And at that time you can find that when you are having stress aisa kuch hai, but others are not having na, you can easily feel that you are having a peculiar sensation inside the body. It is a psychological drama going on inside. So what will be your reaction when it comes? When that comes, what is your response to that? Very good. This is beautiful. You are not answering. That is the first sign of health. The thinking process is going on. Phat karke answer de diya nahi. Yes. Suppose suddenly you have experienced stress. So at that moment of stress, what was your response to that stress?
Going in the flow of the stress. I'm fully experiencing it at times.
You experienced. And after that?
That's what I was saying. So sometimes...
No, what you did or what you do at that time?
So what I do is... Mind runs like anything. 1 minute,
we'll come to that. Huh. Beautiful. Mind runs like anything then?
Sometimes it does figure out that the reason of all this stress or psychological
after that emotion happening is
illogical.
Yes, illogical.
It's for no reason that everything is. I'm reacting so much. So then at that moment, you know, suddenly after that, the disharmony does go away. But it is like, I'm used to being stressed. So in a way, I also don't want it to happen. But somewhere it is also that somehow part of me can't stay without it.
Part of you can't stay without it. Oh, why did you conclude that? What is a guarantee that part of the whole of you can be without? Why did you have a preconceived notion? Kis liye aapne aisa mudra laga diya ki mera kuch hams uske saath jeena hi padega. Anyway, that's a lovely answer. Give one clap. This is something. In olden days, rishi yane koi alag nahi hai. हम लोग भी तुम्हारे जैसे घर में घर से जन्म लेके यहाँ आए हैं. कोई आसमान से या समुद्र से नहीं उठे हैं. आई टोल्ड ना आई वाज अ धानकर स्टूडेंट. सो विद इन अस ओनली ऑल थिंग्स हैपन. तेंदुलकर इज फ्रॉम आवर ओन जनसमूह. वाल्मीकि वाज आवर ओन पॉपुलेशन. आइंस्टीन इज फ्रॉम ह्यूमन पॉपुलेशन, नॉट फ्रॉम मार्स और जुपिटर. सो इन द ह्यूमन बींग इट सेल्फ एवरीथिंग इज हैपनिंग. गुंडा भी इसमें से होता है, संत भी इसमें से होता है, साइंटिस्ट भी यहीं पर होता है, शैतान भी यहीं पर होता है. सो ऑल ऑफ अस हैव गॉट द इन्फिनिट पॉसिबिलिटीज ऑफ बिकमिंग शैतान और संत महात्मा. संत महात्मा डजन मीन लंबा सा दाढ़ी बढ़ाया रुद्राक्ष नहीं. सो दिस इज अनदर दिस वन ऑफ विवेकानंद. स्पिरिचुअलिटी इज फाइंडिंग सोल्यूशंस फॉर द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ लाइफ. व्हाट इज स्पिरिचुअलिटी? फाइंडिंग सोल्यूशंस फॉर द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ लाइफ, इंटरनल एंड एक्सटर्नल. इफ देयर इज अ पेट्रोलियम शॉर्टेज, Vivekananda will tell, if you can find another means, if you can have air as a fuel and run the automobiles, that is part of spirituality. Spirituality should solve the problems of life. If you say, Swamiji, the moment I sit for chemistry examination, andar se kuch hota hai, andar se. Kya hota hai? Dhak dhak lagta hai, kuch hota hai, something. The chemistry of fear. See, fear is the only problem with us. The greatest tragedy of human beings, fear. Vivekananda says, fear is the cause of all the evils in the society, including the countries amassing military strength and atomic bombs. Fear. Remove fear, you are God himself. So now how are you going to tackle fear? Because fear also causes stress. Is it not? Every emotional conflict gives us stress. Now as the stress comes, your stress as you are is so unique that you have to go and see. Others can give you certain suggestions, certain biological remedies, but the real root of stress is where? Red. Where is the real root of stress? Yes, your own mind. So when we want to control mosquitoes, we can have different strategies, is it not? Put on the mosquito curtain, is it not? Easiest. All out, good night, sorry, good afternoon. There is another way. You go to the very breeding ground of mosquitoes and spray anti-mosquito. Is it not? So we have got different strategies. We can take a pill. Go for a movie. Some people, they put something inside. In Kerala, it is given at a cheap rate. Government itself is providing. Tamil Nadu also is providing. And people is standing in those liquor shops are so controlled, so disciplined, so silent and well behaved. Till the maal andar jaane tak. So the root of this problem is in our own mind. Here comes the importance of meditation, importance of self-observation, atma-nirikshan, introspection, because the whole phenomenon is taking place not outside. Scenery is the same, is it not? Situation is your own. So what has been done by me can be undone by myself only. Is it not? Outside things can be changed, but what you are thinking inside, most easiest person is yourself. Maine aisa socha, ab aisa sochunga. Finished. But it's not easy, but it is not impossible. फॉर दैट आई हैव टू ऑब्जर्व इनसाइड, अंदर जो ड्रामा चल रहा है, नाटक, अंदर का जो रंग मंच है मेरा मन का, उसके अंदर ही ये सब नाटक हो रहा है। क्यों हो रहा है भाई? दूसरों के लिए तो नहीं हो रहा है, क्या कारण है? When you remove the cause, you need not have to bother about the effect. Is it not? When the cause is removed, otherwise you take tablets, and so long as the effect of the tablet continues, it stays. Afterwards, it comes with vehemence. Then you take two tablets. Then goes on increasing. Sometimes, somehow you come out of it. That coming out is not because of the tablets, because of something happening inside you. Now, what is the beauty of this point is that if I am not depending on anybody, that is the greatest strength. I am the key, I am the door. Now, I will unlock the door inside. How? I don't want a psychoanalyst. I don't want a psychotherapy doctor. I don't want even gods or anybody in this world. Go inside. That's where the rishis gave that beautiful knowledge. Tattvamasi, you are that. You are that infinite. All power is inside you, Vivekananda says. You can do anything and everything. Stand up. Be bold. Take up the responsibility on your own shoulders and know that you are the makers of your own destiny. This is Vedic mantra. Dekho, koi bhagwan nahi, koi pujari nahi, koi devata nahi, koi mantra nahi. You are the greatest God that ever existed, existing and will ever exist. This is Vivekananda's and our Vedanta's message. Man is the greatest God. इसको छोड़ दिया, मार्बल पत्थर से एक भगवान बनाया, ग्रेनाइट से एक भगवान बनाया, वो सब ठीक है, लेकिन वाइब्रेटिंग एनिमेटिंग डायनामिक गॉड इज देयर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू द ह्यूमन बीइंग। इफ यू कैन नॉट सर्व दिस, ग्रेनाइट का हनुमान को पेड़ा चढ़ाता है ना, मार्बल गणेश मूर्ति को मोदक चढ़ाता है, लेकिन जिंदा गणेश और हनुमान यहां रास्ते में भिखारी के रूप में घूमते हैं, उधर चल चल हट हट। So human being is the greatest God. That infinite power is inside you. This is the second point we have to understand. As a breeding ground of the problem, the very ground has the power to solve the problem. Because every invention of the medicine has been triggered by what? By the very disease. Is it not? The discovery of penicillin was triggered by what? The very disease. After the disease gave him a push, a challenge, he responds back. So when the stress comes next time, now you note down in the diary, when the stress will come, I am not going to define, I am not going to bring all the analysis and definition of somebody. Inside me, garam garam jo chal raha hai, let me be with that stress for a few minutes. I will neither accept nor reject. Let me observe, ye kya kar raha hai, andar bhoot abhi ghus gaya hai. What is it doing now? We have got one weakness, that we have wrong habits for a long time. The power of observation, the power of focusing the mind, we rarely have. Our mind gets focused because of the pressure of examination. Because of the pressure of achievement or performance. But from the childhood, if we can practice the power of focusing the mind on certain thing. In the olden days educational system, this was taught from the very first year. How to focus or concentrate your mind? Ekagrata Shakti, you have to keep track of the time, because if I keep track of the time, my mind wanders. How many of you would love to have Draupadi as your wife? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Draupadi was a great lady, is it not? Along with her came the kingdom also. You want to have Draupadi? If suppose somebody comes and says, exactly like as it was in Mahabharata, Draupadi is waiting. No, suppose if they say, we are ready to give her as your wife. You would like to have, no? But it is not so easy to get a Draupadi. So many kings came, all of them failed, only one hero rose. There is a vessel in which, in the flowing, rotating water, fish was rotating. And it was tied to a pole, and below there was a big vessel containing water, in which the reflection of the moving fish was falling. And it was told, you have to shoot the eye of that fish. You will shoot. Are abhinav bindra bhi nahi kar sakta hai. If you want. But all the kings in those days who were expert dhanurdhari, they could not do. Man with focused attention, Arjuna, a great yogi. And as a student, when the teacher asked during the examination, all others told, Guruji, aapko dekhte hain, hum aasman ko, prithvi ko, sab kuch dekhte hain, are chodo. Ultimately, when Arjuna came, the Guru asked, what do you see? I see only the bird of the parrot. Shoot it, Arjuna. And the arrow flew. Next moment, the bird was down, dead. So the ability to focus on the problems, we are not focusing on the problems. For 2 minutes, vahan dekhte hain, bas. So to get solution, to come out of the stress, really, if you want to independently do it, I have done it myself. It comes like a smoke, like a cloud. Are kahan se bhoot aaya? As you start watching, just watch it. As you start watching, you will find the mind is either accepting it and getting frightened, or saying, get out, get out, get out. Is it not? No, because you have not attempted meditation. Meditation has got nothing to do with spirituality. It has got everything to do with our day-to-day life. Adhyatmikata ke naam par hum ratna moolyon ko khachde ke dabbe mein fek dete hain. Just because it has got the label spirituality, sabko utha ke fek diya. Ye ganda hai. Nahi. Spirituality is the greatest blessing if you understand it properly. Whatever you now see as management, gurus, policies or professionalism, all are in our spiritual books. Because according to India, spirituality is finding solutions for problems of life. Yoga, which is the anti-stress philosophy, it was found so many years before. We want to use Chicago jeans, is it not? French body order. And so many things from other countries. But our own yoga philosophy, yoga hai na wo to, kuch usme gandh aa raha hai na. Spirituality, you get some special smell, is it not? But anything coming from others, from outside our country, why something grand? They are all imitating what we are doing and they are selling it in different brand names. Like Britishers used to take all the cotton from here, make the clothes there and again sell it at a higher cost. So the ability to watch yourself, just watch yourself. So the mind will either accept or reject. If you can watch that also, if you can watch, if we can watch, sit quietly and just try to feel yourself inside the body, and as you start observing, you will find like the traffic vehicles are coming and going, like thoughts are coming and going. As in the traffic, so many vehicles are coming and going, but the traffic police never comes, never goes. Inside you, as thoughts are coming and going, like clouds coming and going, you will find, I am neither coming and going, otherwise I would have gone with the thought. Who will know the second thought that has come? So I am the unchanging entity inside. If I don't change, what doesn't change can never become stressful. Stress came, up to 8:30 I was okay. What is your name?
Kushal.
Kushal. Kushal ta kush ta up to 8:30. Kisi ne bol diya, result mein tumhara number nahi hai. Huh? Bus started. Baad mein jaake dekha ke Kushal ka number first class mein hai. अरे तू नहीं बोला था नंबर नहीं, मैं सोचा तेरे को कहां से फर्स्ट क्लास मिलेगा, इसलिए सेकंड और थर्ड में देखा मैंने, जो आया वो गया ना. सो यू विल फाइंड स्ट्रेस कम्स एंड स्ट्रेस गोस ऑल्सो. सो थॉट इज कैप्चरिंग द सिचुएशन एज स्ट्रेस. Sometime it comes, sometime it goes. As you start watching, you will find stress is coming and stress is going. The very watching will give you knowledge. Nothing to be done. What has to be done now? Madam, what has to be done? You see that stress is individual matter, is it not? The same classroom, all are not having stress. I had it. It comes as a thought, as an experience. And after some time, if my attention is diverted, stress goes away, is it not? I was having stress, suddenly in the classroom somebody started Charlie Chaplin movie. The stress vanishes, is it not, for the time being. Are, after 1 hour you come back, again it comes up. So what is to be done is not to deal with the stress. Deal with the situation which needs our attention. If I have not paid the tax, burning inside will not do anything. Pay the tax and you are free. So here comes the importance of action. What I told, life is action. Going on thinking about it and andar garam ho raha hai. Jo karna hai, you do it that. So action is the only way to remove stress. Stress is the counterpart of worrying, is it not? Worrying doesn't solve the problem at all because it is so unrealistic. What will solve the problem? Action. I am worried. Why? Yahan light nahi hai. Yahan lare bulb laga do na bhai. Put the bulb instead of worrying. Isko kahan iska andhakar hai. Yahan kya karein? What is a step or the solution needed? You implement it. Moment you attend and do it, stress stops. So action is the only remedy for the stress management. One is internal action and secondly external action. Suppose if you have not read some of the chapters, what you should do, don't go on boiling inside, read those chapters. Is it not? Or suppose in the examination hall you are sitting and you find 2 questions have come from the chapters which you had omitted. Now what can you do? You can do 2 things. One is to get stressed up. By getting stressed up, you are not going to get the answers. That is very clear. You must be clear in your mind. Under pressure build up karne se stress ya answer nahi hota hai. 2 things we can do. What is the easiest thing to do? Get the answers. 2 questions have come from the chapters you have omitted. Now you are getting some stress. How to release the stress? Immediately. One of the most easiest method.
Do the question.
Huh?
Do the other question.
Are next boy is sitting, look at his paper, na? What? No, no.
I was the answer.
This is, there is one way out, is it not? Right or wrong is another thing. One way is, moment you see, get the answer, finished. Problem is solved now. Of course it is wrong, because in the life you cannot copy. The boy who copied in the interview, both the boys were called for the same company's interview. But during the interview he could not copy. But stress, that is one action. Another one is, by worrying and beating myself, I am not going to get the answer. Rather I will be spoiling the existing question's answer. So become calm and quiet. This is rational thinking. Chinta karne se samasyaon ka samadhan nahi hota hai. Chinta nahi, fikar karne se. Because thinking is one thing, worrying is one thing. Worrying doesn't give the answer. You act on this, you should have studied those 2 chapters. The second alternative is to copy. जिंदगी जीने वालों के लिए है, डर फुक जैसा मरने वालों के लिए नहीं है. What I did, you know, life, fortune favors the daring. 4th year, Dhanukar College, I am attending the commerce. We have to write 5 questions. 5 questions out of 8 we have to answer. One question, I am finding I know only 4. I have not done anything wrong. The question which I knew perfectly, I wrote 2 times. I have not done anything wrong. Of course, I stood first in the whole college in mercantile law. Of course, without that also, I would have got the pass mark. It's an internal examination. I found the professor has answered that question also. Given marks to that question also. Are Telugu itna mark kaisa mila? Avala class se bahara baad mein dikhata hun. The second question I answered, the first question, second question. Lastly, I answered the same second question again. This was just for fun, but fortune favors the daring. And there was no adharma in that. I have not copied. What I had, I have given. And you are released from the stress. With that clarity of mind, now you see what can be done. The third one is to understand that stress and getting worried is not the solution. Action is the solution. Do what is to be done there. And if you find that you are going to fail by not answering, get ready for that. That is where you get the courage. Yes, I am ready to fail. Kya hoga? Kuch nahi hone wala hai. Kya hoga? Are all big people, they was, all of them have failed. Dhirubhai Ambani, Raman Maharshi, Albert Einstein, Newton, all of them were failures in the academic life. But in the real life, that is where andar ka jaddum thakat, inner strength. So you require that inner strength to act and find a solution. Otherwise, what happens, you know, in all the stress management meeting, I find everybody wants, Swamiji, please tell, immediately they will note down. And I was telling the story of one boy who was married to a woman and his views are another girl. Moment I told, you live according to the Indian dharma. Saat chakkar kata hai, usko agni sakshi midya hai. Acha, Swamiji, let me note. I told, don't note it, act on it. Ghar mein jaake, apne bibi se apology, maafi mango. That is not doing. Whatever I am telling, all these things, he is taking the quotation, through WhatsApp he is sending to another person. I told that information doesn't do anything in life. Transformation is a part of life. For transformation, action is important. Nahi to apne Ved, Puran, sab granto mein sab kuch likha hai, lekin kuch nahi hota hai jindagi mein. One day Vivekananda went to Sri Ramakrishna. Sri Ramakrishna told, information is nothing. Transformation is a real thing. Parivartan. Then he told his almanac. What do you call panchang bolte na almanac? Usko utao. So what is the indication? He told today 15 inches rainfall. It is written that today is according to the weather forecast 15 inches rainfall. And Sri Ramakrishna told just squeeze the panchang. He squeezed it. How many drops of water you are getting? Not a single drop. That is only an information. By squeezing the weather forecast, you won't get rainfall. Rainfall has to come from there. So the action must be there in our life. Information is nothing. You can download any amount of information from the net regarding the stress. Stress is not in the net. Inside you. So the action also proceeds from there. So in that action is the part of our life. Life means action. And can we do this action calm and quietly? Really action, real action, intense action can start only when it is done in a mood of quietness or calmness. You will find always when the action is intense at the supreme height, it will look, it is very still, calm and quiet. When the fan rotates, of course this is a Katara fan. When the fan rotates in full speed, intensely, na, you can't see the blade. It's so silently it is rotating. And when a man is sharpening the pencil, na, intensely concentrated. When a man is shooting, At that time, even if the mosquito bites, he will not bother. If he's a real photographer. The whole mind is flowing. He's so calm. And when the cat wants to catch a rat, you have seen? Have you observed a cat trying to catch a pigeon? He's so calm and quiet, is it not? Everything is out. So much focus, absolute silence. And in that silence, when it wants to catch the pigeon, it is such a mesmeric effect that pigeon stays quiet and it jumps. We can watch this thing, the nature, that always behind intense activity, there is perfect calmness. Like Sri Krishna, so much of arrows are flying here and there, perfectly calm. The calmest cap in India had Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Avi Chalit. Keep the mind so calm and quiet. Jo kuch hota hai, sa dekhta hai. It comes through a little detachment, non-attachment, anasakti. Keep yourself little free in a light, nice, jolly mood. Don't take everything so seriously. Itna serious bana diya, jo kuch nahi tha, oh, sab kuch ho gaya. Jo sab kuch tha, usko chhod diya. So, if you want to have an intense activity, action is best only when it's intense. When Bhimsen Joshi is singing Kshetra Vittala, Tirtha Vittala, utterly lost, is it not? So silent inside, except that he doesn't know anything. So Tanmayata, I see Lagi Lagan, Mira Hogai Magan, Koto Gali Gali Hari Guna Gane Lagi. So are you so much getting focus? So in that intensity of action, it is backed by calmness, so calm that the whole mind is flowing like one single stream of oil, no break in between. So to observe the stress, I must totally focus. I know in our college, some of the things you should not record. Jab ladka line marta hai na, when he's behind some girl na, he's so totally focused, nothing disturbs him. Day and night, dream, waking, sleep, everywhere. How did he get that power of concentration? Are kahan se ladki aayi? How you get focused? That means the power of focusing is already inside you. Now you chose to focus. During examination, you don't get so much focus, na? But when you get a BF or GF, the whole mind, oh, aisa jata ekdam. As if 5 HP motor is pumping water with so much speed, it is going there. So the action to have its perfection and the highest effect, try to maintain calmness. In sports, this is called sportsman spirit. So even when you get a loss, no, you are not disturbed or shattered inside. Make it a habit. Every time you start a work, and that is why in India we have a ritual. The Christians will do like this. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Thoda sa aisa kar liya, Bhagawan ka naam liya. So that the mind is prepared to get a calm base. And from there the action should start. Even cricketers. Shrikant, Sachin, Tendulkar, bat ko aisa gumate, upar asman ko, suraj ko dekhte hain. So that is a ritual, but it is having a scientific, psychologically scientific basis, creating a background of quietness. So when the mind is quiet, the ability to focus becomes more. Sri Ramakrishna used to say, if a thread has to be put inside the needle, what we do first? When a thread is to be put inside the ear of the needle, what we do first? Huh? Loudly. No. Yes. Just sharpen and then put. Otherwise, the scattered parts of the thread will not allow the thread to go inside the ear of the needle. Similarly, the mind has to be focused. All the great people, Lata Mangeshkar, Bhimsen Joshi, M.S. Subbulakshmi, when they are in the height of their performance, absolutely lost. Is it not? Totally lost. So when you are not there, how beautiful is it? You are not there. When you are totally lost in that subject, the whole action, the whole energy goes into it. And when you are not there, who is the feeler of the stress? So there are two I inside you. One, the so-called lower I, my, jisko ahankar bolte hai. One who feels the whole trouble, another watching the whole trouble going on. So the same man, when he goes to sleep at night, what happens? When you sleep, what happens? Of course, if you have too much of stress, it will not allow you to go into sleep. But once you go into the sleep, what happens? What happens? Absolute quietness, relaxed. Where are you during the sleep? No. Where are you? In sleep, where are you? Chinmay. That is called Chinmay, awakened. In sleep, where are you? You are nowhere. Your body is there, but you are nowhere. Before sleep, in the dream, you were wandering in Hollywood, Bollywood, so many places. But moment you enter into the sleep, you are not there. Early morning, you come, and along with you, all the stress comes. So that whole package called Chinmay, feeling the stress, he is the stress. Somebody told, you are not in the traffic, sir. You are the traffic. You move little, the traffic will get cleared. बीच में गाड़ी को ऐसा खड़ा कर दिया, सो ही क्रिएटेड एन ऑब्स्टेकल. ऐ वही इतना हॉर्न बजा रहा है, अरे हटो, इतना ट्रैफिक जाम क्यों हो रहा है? यू आर नॉट इन द ट्रैफिक, यू आर द ट्रैफिक. पुलिस ने पकड़ के उसका गाड़ी ऐसा सीधा गया, हटो यहां से. विद इन वन मिनट सब कट 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 निकल गया, एवरीथिंग वेंट अवे. सो यू आर द तत्वमसी, एंड वेन यू आर द स्ट्रेस, मैन इज वॉट इज थॉट्स आर, इज इट नॉट? इफ योर थॉट्स आर रिमूव, यू आर नोवेयर. यू आर द थिंकर. Thinker is the thoughts. Without thoughts, there is no thinker. The thinker is absent in the deep sleep. Is it not? Trees make the jungle. There is no jungle. Thoughts make the thinker. Waters make the river. But we are so fascinated with the words. It's called verbal illusion. Nadi, nadi, nadi kuch nahi hai. Hajaram boond, ek ke piche ek. रफ्तार से चल रही है, वही नदी है, है ना? ड्रीम, बट आई वेन यू स्लीप, ड्रीम इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम स्लीप. Dream is one thing, sleep is another. In the dream, the part of the waking state continues. In sleep, that's why in the dream you are present. That's why it is told that you are the traffic. So you are the problem. So the whole personality of ours comes, that is why we are having the problem in the same hall, whereas others are not having. So now if this is all I'm giving, certain things which you will not get in the so-called psychoanalysis. In India, we have arrived at it, but it is a sure remedy. Once you hit at it, it's difficult, but once you get into it and hit at it, you get the technique. Then you don't require any tablets, any other thing. But before that, at the lower level, so many things will be going on. That I will come to those also. बट नाउ वंस यू फील दैट, अरे मेरे अंदर में मेरे चिंताओं के कारण ही स्ट्रेस को मैं अनुभव कर रहा हूं, तो जस्ट इन द ट्रैफिक मैन टोल्ड, अरे सो मच ट्रैफिक, आर यू नॉट स्टैंडिंग इन द ट्रैफिक? सो आर यू नॉट द ट्रैफिक? सो यू आर द ट्रैफिक, बट इसे नहीं, मैं नहीं हूं, बाकी सब ट्रैफिक है. अरे तुम्हारा गाड़ी निकालो पहले यहां से. नाउ वील कम टू द पॉइंट, प्लीज वॉच, आई एम नॉट कमिंग टू एनी स्पिरिचुअलिटी. If you are the stress, what can be done? There are two standpoints here. One is, you are not the stress. Stress is the observed thing and you are the observer, the experiencer. Another is, you are the stress. If you are the stress, what can you do? A little loudly. No, nothing can be done. पुलिस है, चोर है, पुलिस चोर को पकड़ सकता है. पुलिस ही जब चोर बनता है, अब क्या कर सकता है? कोई नहीं पकड़ सकता है उसको. दैट इज वॉट इज हैपनिंग इन इंडिया. एंड वेन यू कांट वेन यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस इज इन द साइकोलॉजिकल फील्ड एज यू वॉच द थॉट यू फाइंड आई एम दैट थॉट्स. The stress is in me. I am the one who is exactly experiencing. Others are not experiencing. The so-called, what is your name you told?
Kushal.
Kushal is what? Your thoughts, na? Between you and her and me, what is the difference? Body is different. This is a different unit. But inside, the real thing which is working, it is your thoughts, na? Your thoughts are different, his thoughts are different, Narendra Modi's thoughts are different, Sonia Gandhi's thoughts are different. That is what is differentiating each one. Bahar se to samosa ek hi jaisa lagta hai, modak bhi ek jaisa lagta hai, lekin kisi kisi modak mein nariyal hota hai, kisi kisi modak mein dal hota hai, kisi kisi modak mein hum malai bhi rakh sakte hain. So inner contents makes a real man, is it not? Outside this is only a package, a covering. The body is exactly the same. But inside, what differentiates you and me is my thought currents, na? This thought becomes actions afterwards. Without thought, there can't be any action. Not even a silly action, even an insignificant action cannot come outside unless you have a thought inside. There's a famous scientist who invented laughing gas. One day he was teaching, and as he was experimenting with the laughing gas, he just took in some of that gas. He breathed in some of that gas and suddenly he went into an ecstatic state. Just as you take some drugs, your mind goes into another state of existence. You have different experiences. Daru pine se bhi hota hai aisa. Then suddenly he found Humphrey Davies, that was his name, the scientist's name. Any chemistry students are here? Science students are here, you told? Chemistry, nobody is there. What is laughing gas? Nitrogen, something, it comes. So he just took in the nitrogen, he inhaled it, and suddenly he found that all the students have disappeared from the class. It's a real incident. And in the place of the students, he found bunches of thoughts were sitting on the benches. Then he said, oh, these are all the real students. The thought inside and outside is the body. Like the motor inside the car, without the engine or the motor, however beautiful Innova you may have, it will not run. So mind is the motor of this universe and the mind is the motor of your personality. So those thoughts are your so-called Kushal. If Kushal himself is the chor, kaun pakadega usko abhi? Kushal was supposed to do the police, na? Police giri karna chahiye tha usko. Now police himself is the chor, now who is going to catch him? Similarly, as you understand, so I am the stress. Somebody external to me can act on me, is it not? How can I act? I am the stress. I did it. I have no time to explain this, not with the stress, with my migraine. Moment I found that I am the pain, the man who wanted to remove the pain is no more there. When I am the pain, I found nothing can be done. If something else is the pain, then I can do something on that. When I am the pain, as I was looking at it, nothing can be done. Moment that knowledge came, nothing can be done, I didn't know what happened. The shooting pain was there in the migraine. First I was thinking, there is a pain, 1,000 hammers are striking my head. Then immediately my mind found out that you are the experiencer of the pain. Is it not? I am experiencing the pain. At the same time I am telling, I don't want the pain. And if you don't want the pain, if you don't want to attend this session of stress management, who asked you to enter inside? You could have walked off, is it not? After coming here, no, I don't want to attend the stress management. Now there is a stress now. Is it not? Simply you entered, you don't want to attend, you want to go out, but you are not able to go out. So I thought, I am experiencing the migraine and I want that migraine to be spat out. So my mind itself started questioning, if you don't want to have the migraine, why do you experience it at all? This is something very strange that happened to me. So from that time, nearly 17 years, I have not touched tablets. Previously, I used to take 2 paracetamol for the migraine. And as soon as I felt that, if I am the pain, nothing can be done, absolute silence. When nothing can be done, the whole thing collapsed. That silence is the silence of intense activity of meditation. This is a thing which you can do. When the thought comes, just observe. ये कहां से आया भाई, अभी तक तो नहीं था, 8:30 बजे तक कहां से आया अभी. Now you are listening to these talks. Night 9:30 or 10 o'clock, you will go to your room. Is it not? You will sit there and sit on your cot, and as you will take a notebook or some books to read, suddenly this whole scenery and the morning session will come into your mind. Is that real? Arey, that session was over by 12:30, 1 o'clock. Now what is happening to me is my thought about those session. It is not real, yet I am experiencing it. So who created that? You. And you are that thought. And who will remove it? You have to remove it by two approaches. One is, I am the seer of the thought, so I am not the thought. The shirt is mine, but I am not the shirt. The stress is mine, but I am not the stress. You try it slowly. Don't try to impose it artificially with force. Through knowledge. Knowledge is power. Knowledge will release you from parishram. Parishram se tume vimukta kara deta hai gyan. Suppose there is a bottle of Mirinda. You come rushing, and as you approach the bottle of Mirinda, you find a small label, poison. What will you do now? Madam, you came with so much of eagerness to drink the Mirinda. Then you find a label, poison. What will you do now? What will you take action, or what action will you perform? There was an effort to take the cold drink, and you had an information, it's poison. What will you do now? Huh? What you will do? You will not do that thing. Though for communication you are telling, you will not do anything. Simply chhod diya. Mirinda pine ka jo ichha hai, usko simply drop. You become silent. So inside, when we see anger is poisonous, that is a knowledge that poison will kill you, released you from the effort. What was the effort? A poison likha hai, main nahi piyungi. A poison likha hai, main nahi piyungi. Are you struggling? Why you are not struggling? Why? You have the knowledge that poison is dangerous. Similarly, do you have the knowledge that anger is dangerous? Moment, 1 minute. Moment you know that, immediately the very knowledge makes that action drop. You will not be struggling 10 years not to drink that Mirinda. Similarly, here also, when you see the stress and that knowledge that I am not the stress, time is getting over, na? Inside analysis will not go. Very experience of yours will tell, yes, I am the observer. Stress is the observed thing. I have done it again and again. The very knowledge as it comes, yes, that is separate from me, nothing need be done, goes. When you don't do anything, the mind is perfectly silent. In that silence, you are not there. And you are that stress in a way. Both way it works, like a chess, double check deta hai na chess mein. I have done it. I am not the stress. Nothing to be done with the stress. I am okay. And another is, I am the stress. If I am the stress, what has to be done? Nothing has to be done. Because if stress is something, I can do something external to me. It's mic, usko repair kar sakta hun. But can the mic repair itself? Can your bike repair itself? That is why when we go mad, we go to somebody else to repair. Our brains are our mind. Small, small things, we may put something on our body if there is a wound. But if you have to operate your heart. So when you slowly understand that I am that, you don't do anything. The very realization, it's a very subtle thing. But once you can act upon it, usko pick up karne se na. Even cycling was very difficult when I attempted. But after 2-3 days, when you persist, you find, yeah, rasta khul gaya, hai isko pakdo. Now I don't do anything, just watch. Because whole life is in the mind as thought. We are all living this life inside the mind, not outside. That is why physically the world is the same. The same sun, star, moon, earth, rivers. But experience is individualistic, is it not? Each one of you get your own individual experience out of the external scenery. So the situation is yours. We had an economics professor. And we used to tell, we are purposely attending the economics class. Why, you know? Yesterday night we could not sleep. Got the point? Very nicely, we used to go and relax and sleep and then come out. Oh, madam ne bahut accha sulaya hum logon ko, accha lag raha hai abhi. And see, same professor, same classroom, same subject, and some of the students are very intensely listening. So where was the deviation or the variation? It's inside me. So these two approach, one is identifying with the stress and understanding that if I am the stress, if police understands he is the chore, what he has to do? He cannot catch himself, na? Just leave it. So he becomes a real police. Bereft of that, tendencies of the thief. Till that time nothing can be done. Because you are supposed to catch the thief, but you yourself are behaving like a thief. Moment the police understands, that understanding is the way of knowledge. Similarly, when you understand anger is really bad, that understanding comes inside. Andar gyan ho jata hai. Dekhne se, observe karne se, chahne se. Do you really want? Last time also we asked this question. Kushal wants to go to bathroom now? You want to go to washroom? No. But when the pressure builds up, what he will do? Are Kushal, daud ke chala gaya. Do you have that urgency pressure to solve the stress now? You would have run. You would have solved it. So we are not so intent, not finding the urgency to solve, postpone kar diya usko. But when the pressure comes, Swamiji, you please wait, you continue. I will afterwards listen from the video. Sri Ramakrishna gives this example. When the nature's call comes, day before yesterday, one Swamiji was telling, we all went to Dehradun. 40 aadmi, 2 sandas. Jisko jahan jagah mila, bottle mein, bucket mein, kisi mein paani lekar, ped ke niche, idhar udhar, everybody sat. Well, the pressure was so much. That is a sign of an enthusiastic, enterprising nature. Pressure, we are all so mediocre. Doodh mein bija hua chivda. Sri Ramakrishna is just, itna nambi pambi gudi gudi, haan, theek hai, adjust karo na, theek hai na, hota hai na, chalega. Arre, kaisa chalega, bhai? Haan, itna ghusa kyun hota hai? Arre, nahi chalega, isliye ghusa aata hai. We accept, accommodate. It is glorified. It's okay. But internally, no, I want it. When you really want it, that's called pressure. How Sri Ramakrishna gives a brilliant example. Somebody told how to have the God realization. Do you really want it? Then he gives this example. A child told his mother that, Mom, when I want to go to the bathroom, will you please wake me up at 2 o'clock? Mom told, no, I need not. The pressure will wake you up. And when Sri Ramakrishna wanted to see the God, the pressure was so much. One day he saw that in the Kali temple, the dagger was hanging. Simply went to cut his neck. Told, if I am not getting your darshan, O Kali Mata, why should I leave? The pressure was so much. He told, my apna jaan balidan de dunga. At that time, Mother Kali, she appeared. And when that comes, that's something fantastic, you are not there. There was a man in Greece or Rome, I don't know. He had a problem given by the king. And if he doesn't give the solution, he may be punished. The pressure becomes so much within 1 week. On the 7th day, he was a grown-up man. Rasta mein aise nange daudne laga. Are, Eureka, Eureka, Eureka. Because there was no book to copy the answer. You know, Eureka, Archimedes. From where he got? It is not in the books. No other person utilized, I will ask somebody, nobody could tell. At that time, if you have the urgency, the real need, real pressure, are you sincere, therefore? or just bluntly put a question, Swamiji answer kijiye. Stress does not go by imaginary questions and imaginary action. It wants actual intense action, something to be done on that. And because stress is not really happening from outside, it is inside, it is at a psychological level. So it has to be operated upon from the psychological field only. External thing, what you can do, you can take a stress-releasing tablet. Is it not? We are getting a lot of stress-releasing, depression-releasing tablets. So many tablets have come now. Yesterday only I read about few tablets, not because of this, in this connection. It came because of certain, one of the drug which was banned in India. And Kerala is using those drugs. Some company was confiscated by that, for that. In yesterday's news it had come. And some of them, one big ashrama or some company, na? One big organization connected with some activities. So they had all these drugs. Oh, one who was hypnotizing and teaching mesmerism. Yesterday news it has come. He had all these drugs. He was teaching mesmerism, hypnotism and other things. That can temporarily release you. But temporary release is not a remedy. Wapas aayega. So other one is, the stress agitates your whole system, is it not? Physically you can feel it. Hundreds of secretion going on in the body, chemical secretion. Sometimes you may even want to pass urine immediately, is it not? In stress I have found some of the patients have passed number two also, because the system can't bear that load. The very system is reacting, nothing to laugh. There's knowledge, you see how the whole system is reacting. The one way is to quieten the system. How to quieten the system? They told, do pranayama. The breathing, which is the flywheel of the whole system. If breathing changes, your mental condition also can change. Yeah, you can experiment with a child. When a child comes scolding, you'll be gasping, is it not? Within a moment, the whole breathing process undergoes a radical change. Similarly, when you are perfectly concentrated, you will find the breathing is flowing like a silk thread. They say, if you cannot control from the internal, from the external, go inside. So breathing and the internal system, you can experiment. Slowly take deep breath. Not now, afterwards. Today also there will be no time for guided meditation, I think. That is one system. And there is another thing called Nadi Shuddhi, rhythmic breathing. The breathing goes in a rhythmic way. These things you can get in the net. Another way is, this is also a little difficult, but if you persist, it will come. This is in our yoga system. Whenever you get a negative thought, put the opposite thoughts. Suppose if you are afraid, try to think of a lion, think of Muhammad Ali, or think of some great events. And the very existence and the coming in of those thoughts will drive away these thoughts of fear. This also is a temporary. But as you continuously go on doing it, for 1 or 2 years, you will find the moment the fear comes, the connected thought which is opposite, it also comes and drives away the fear. This is yogic method of meditation. You have to do it with emotional involvement and seriousness. That is one thing. And the last way is, you have to find out what can be done to remove the stress. Ask the question, I am getting stressed out. Even my mother can't put her hand inside my heart and remove that stress. What can I do? What is the way out of it? Just ask the question to your mind, how to come out of it? Don't tell it is so powerful, so overpowering that I can't ask. Because if you put those again, negative thoughts, you are closing the door. Just ask, what can be done? What can be done? What can be done? Keep on persisting. After 3rd or 4th day, chatak, you get the answer. You get it. Now I'll give you 3 different methods in which the Ramakrishna movement's saints have given a very simple solution to have the stress management strategy. It is neither spiritual nor connected with anything, but it's so real and simple. And what is simple is easy to miss. That is one of the famous dictums of Shiv Khera. What is easy to see is easy to miss. It is so easy that we don't bother about it. The first method is Vivekananda's method. It is called face the brute. Directly gunde ko samna, gunde ka samna karo. Face the brute. One day Swami Vivekananda, who was a messenger of courage, as he was passing through the streets of Kashi, Varanasi, the famous city of Banaras, on one side there was a huge wall, on another side there was a big pond. As he was walking with a stick in his hand, suddenly 10 to 12 monkeys jumped from the tree and they started chasing Vivekananda. We are not habituated. Sometimes dogs chase us, but rarely we get this experience of 10 to 12 monkeys chasing. So the normal tendency is, okay, let us avoid confrontation. So he was walking little fast. More he walked fast, more the monkeys came chasing. He started running. The monkeys also started running and chasing him. Some of the monkeys pulled his dhoti. Some of the monkeys clawed at him. And he ran faster still. Jaan hatheli me leke Swami Vivekananda bhaag rahe the. What a personality, is it not? Have you seen the photo of Swami Vivekananda? He says, I started running. And from the other side of the pond, one man who was standing there, he told, Jangliyo ka samna karo, daudo nahi. And Vivekananda said, moment those words entered me, face the brute, do not run. I found adrenaline rushing inside me, and the next moment I turned myself. And Swami Vivekananda with big eyes, he told, Chha, maine kya kaam kiya? Tuch bandar log mujhe picha kar rahe hain? Dar phuk mai bhaag raha ho? Mai to chidananda roop shivokam anant amar atma ho, mere liye to koi mrityu nahi hai. There is a spiritual knowledge. He turned back, and the moment he turned, first dramatic magic thing that happened was monkeys, they got frightened because they were chasing, and suddenly he turned, they never expected. They stood simply stunned. And then Vivekananda Swamiji took the stick and was about to beat. Now monkeys started running and Vivekananda Swamiji chased. Nearly 15 to 20 seconds, all the monkeys were driven away. Then the knowledge came to him. Standing on the platform of New York, talking to the Westerners, he told, this is one lesson, my friends, I learned from my life. Challenges, dangers, crisis, and situations come. Like a coward, don't run away. Face them with your full face. Face the brute. When there is a fear of examination, face that. When there is laziness, face it. When there is jealousy, face it. Encounter it. Uske saath haath milao. Milo usse. Kya hai? Why you are getting afraid of anger and asking somebody else how to control the anger? Anger is yours. Is it not? Anger is mine. I am asking somebody else how to control my anger. Oh, to aapka hai. So this is one of our method. When problem comes, face the brute. Mathematics. I had this problem, you see. That's why I took lower mathematics instead of higher mathematics. So in the SSLC examination, this was before reading Vivekananda, I was so much worried about this algebra and mathematics. Whatever has to be multiplied, I divided. And whatever was to be divided, I multiplied. I remember how these incidents put their memory. And you should know how to deal with your memory as you start doing the meditation. Because memory is one of the important things that can cause stress. In fact, the very stress is because of the memory. Then in the SSLC vacation, I took all the problems one by one and solved it. Action. Moment I solved, the fear went away. The incident happens outside. After the incident is over, you carry forward those incidents through the memory. Memory goes inside and it comes out as a thought. Just like you have got the RAM in the computer. Remove the RAM, the computer will not work. So that memory, when it comes out as a thought, you consider it as so real, and again you get the stress. Is it not? But that memory is when you are at your room, 10 o'clock night. But the incident happened somewhere, is it not? Or it may happen tomorrow morning. But you are now inside the room. At that moment, why are you getting stressed? There is nothing to be stressed. But the thought brings that in the form of memory. The Bombay used to say, hul dikata hai kya? You know hul dikana? You don't know what is hul dikana? Suppose somebody is standing like this. Like that, you do know, he gets frightened little. You can do this with many of the animals. Dog is there. Dog also will get little frightened. So hul dikana. आई डोंट नो, इन बॉम्बे इट वाज ओल्ड लैंग्वेज व्हेन वी वर द हूल दिखाता है क्या, इन्हें डराता है क्या. सो दैट थॉट कम्स टू योर माइंड बट यू रियली फाइंड इट इज नॉट द रियल इंसिडेंट ना, इट इज ओनली यूर थॉट ना. थॉट इज लाइक ए फोटोग्राफ. Your mother's photograph is not your mother. Once that idea dawns in your mind, the thoughts are coming and torturing me, the very knowledge will tell, don't be bothered about these thoughts. They are unreal. What can be done to the unreal thing? Nothing. And when you do nothing, you are calm and quiet. And from that calm and quiet base, again you act. When you take action from a confused brain, it will be a confused answer. When the mind becomes calm and quiet because of this knowledge, from there you act. A clear brain can give clear solution. A confused brain, whenever you are having confused brain or stress, for the time being, wait. How to wait? Hey Kushal, thoda shant ho jana. Relax yaar. Be quiet. Don't worry. Are you hot? You are all seeing so many movies, but nothing you learn from movies. All is well. You know that, na? All is well. See, I happened to see it in the flight. Suddenly something caught my eyes. I was not having the microphone or the thing. Then something is happening. You know that some movie was there, na? Where your famous Satyameva Jayate hero was. Three
Idiots.
Oh, Three Idiots, yes. I got this CD from Pune Engineering College. There I gave a talk, I told Swamiji, whatever you are talking about education, all these things, it is there. There I found all is well. The counter stress. Actually we should have stress elimination, not stress management. Why do you want to manage the stress? Why don't you eliminate it? Some of the things are stress management. Watching the thought, observing the stress as it is arising, like a bubble coming from the bottom of the well and bursting on the surface of the well water, as you find this thing come and as you watch, stress will go away. External problem may not be solved. That problem will be solved only when you directly attend to that problem, act on it and then clear it. Got the point? If I want to come first in mercantile law, worrying and getting stressed is one thing. Second is I should read the chapters of mercantile law, answer it and finish it. Is it not? So these two things we have to differentiate and have a clarity that one is simply imagination, another is real action. So this is the first method which we use in Ramakrishna Math. Face the brute. Pura apna thakat ke saath jujaro dhil se lado. And if you success or fail, don't worry, accept both. We are ready to accept success as well as failure. At least I have the satisfaction I fought. Is it not? And what is the guarantee that you are going to fail? What is the guarantee? Maybe that other person will fail. But you are imagining I am going to fail, is it not? Kya hoga? Stress hota hai. Suppose you put the question, if other man is going to fail, was immediately it is cleared. So thought worry arises out of imagination, not the actual situation. The second is the method of Sharada Devi. She was the consort of Sri Ramakrishna. All of us are handling it, but you can do it consciously, voluntarily, with knowledge. Suppose if you are not able to face the brute, sometime it happens. Big political leader comes, you can't face them. Hai na? पीछे से 10 गुंडों को लगा देंगे. अब क्या करूं? कैन यू हैव 10 गुंडास? सो शारदा देवी मदर, होली मदर, शी सेज प्रे टू द लॉर्ड, प्रे टू गॉड विथ टीयर्स, विथ इमोशन. मेनी टाइम्स आवर प्रेयर्स आर आंसर्ड, इज इट नॉट? आवर प्रेयर्स आर आंसर्ड. हाउ मच इंटेंसली यू प्रे, इट हैपन्स. एंड समटाइम इट इज लाइक अ मिराकल. वेदर यू कॉल इट सुपरस्टिशन और एनीथिंग, यू आर नॉट बॉदर्ड. अपने को काम आता है भाई, इस्तेमाल करो उसको. इट इज गिविंग सम सोल्यूशन ना. हाँ, इट इज ए इंडियन सुपरस्टिशन. मारो गोली, इंडियन सुपरस्टिशन. अरे इट इज यूजफुल टू मी ना. आई यूज्ड प्रेयर. इफ इंडिया हैड नॉट हैड दिस वंडरफुल आर्ट ऑफ प्रेयर, मेनी पीपल वुड हैव गॉन मैड. जस्ट बाय प्रेयर द एंटायर फोर्स ऑफ द स्ट्रेस दे पोर थ्रू द प्रेयर एंड दे आर फ्री. नो टैबलेट, नो डायग्नोस्टिक फीस, नथिंग. नो साइकोनालिस्ट, नथिंग. भगवान से प्रार्थना किया, प्रभु ये क्या हो रहा है, हनुमान जी बजरंगबली बचाइए ना. उसमें से उसका स्ट्रेस निकल जाता है कम से कम, बाद में जो होगा होता है. हाउ ब्यूटिफुल नाइट समथिंग व्हेन इट इज सुपर इंटेलिजेंट ना वी कांट एक्सेप्ट इट, इट गोज अबव आवर ब्रेन. इन द फैमिली लाइफ सो मच ऑफ प्रॉब्लम कम्स, गो टू गॉड, प्रे, वीप, इन दैट द होल स्ट्रेस इज डाइल्यूटेड. द एक्सटर्नल सिचुएशन मे नॉट चेंज बट यू आर फ्रीड फ्रॉम द मेंटल टॉर्मेंट एंड द टॉर्चर ऑफ स्ट्रेस. How beautiful. Prayer, somehow one of the most fascinating thing of Indian spirituality. Pray to God and things are happening. I don't know how. It is the most invisible and mystical law. Even for your ordinary things also, very mildly you pray. I want to do Bachelor of Arts, is it not? Then you start search for a college, either Ruya College or Parle College or some, then get admitted. Then your prayer, then you say, my wish, my aspiration, my ambition is successful. Ambition is nothing but another form of prayer. Andar hi andar poocha, humko become graduate banna hai. Hai ki nahi? Inside you are putting that prayer and you act on it. Sometimes after praying, if you are finding it possible to act, act on it. Sometimes prayer also is not answered. There's a beautiful conversation with God and the devotee. One day God calls the devotee, hello. He says, oh, who are you? God speaking. Oh, you got some time today? So many times I gave you missed calls, you never attended. Till today I am leisurely. So many people had given calls. Yours was in the line. I am coming to you. Do you have anything to ask? Please tell quickly, 5 minutes. And this man told, oh God, many times I pray to you. Do you listen to my prayers? Well, yes. But sometimes I find that there is no answer. And God replied, I answered. Which was the prayer? I answered all the prayers. Now this particular two prayers, I did answer. When? I told no. And you never accepted no as my reply. So sometimes God says, no, don't try to become the prime minister. One of my brother was a manager in Union Bank in somewhere Nasik. He resigned and came running. It was, Are Baba, ye MP, MLA, gundon ka itna pressure hai. I resigned from the manager's post. He is now in Goregaon. Afterwards, again he got the manager's post somewhere in Bombay. This side, he accepted. It happens, you see. So when the prayer is not answered, sometimes it may be for our good also. And the third approach of Sri Ramakrishna is super brilliant, but we may not accept because we are not up to that level. But it is naturally happening. He says, Ramji ka Ichha. Whatever is happening in this world is due to the Bhagavan ki marji se, unki Ichha se, ye sab chalte. There was a man who was a Vaishnava Bhakta. So daily used to chant the name Ram, 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 Ram like that. Dukan bhi chalata hai, apna business bhi karta hai, ye bhi chal raha hai. So in that village, dacoits came, they looted 2-3 rich people's house, and while coming, they could not carry the load. Seeing innocent man, and he's a bhakta, kyunki bahut tilak vilak laga ke sab baitha tha wahan par, are sala chal yahan par, to bola ab kya kare, chaku dikhaya usko, marne se acha inke piche jana theek hai, and temporarily has to save himself, otherwise they will stab him. Bola pakdo, uske sir pe 50 kilo ka ek load laga diya, chalo hamare sath. कहां तक हम दिखा देंगे, बाद में तुमको सेफली वापस दुकान में छोड़ देंगे. सो ही वॉज गोइंग. इन द मीन टाइम द विलेज मुखिया, ही गेव इंफॉर्मेशन टू पोलिस, पोलिस हैड कम एंड दे केम चेजिंग दिस डेकॉइट्स. सेंसिंग दिस पोलिस कमिंग, ऑल द डेकॉइट्स रैन अवे. और ये जो बुद्धू या बेबस था, लैक ऑफ इंटेलिजेंस और इनोसेंस, दिस फेला वॉज स्लोली वॉकिंग एंड पोलिस कॉट हिम. और चोर सलाक कहीं के बोले, नहीं नहीं नहीं, मैंने चोरी नहीं किया, दिया एकता पर सामान है सिर के ऊपर, चोरी नहीं किया तुमने, चलो. सो दे टुक हिम इनटू द पुलिस वैन एंड ही वाज पुट इनसाइड द सेल. नेक्स्ट डे मॉर्निंग व्हेन द इंक्वायरी केम एंड द जज केम, ही वाज ब्रॉट बिकॉज ही वाज द ओनली चोर हु वाज कॉट, ऑल अदर चोर दे हैव रन अवे. सो द जज आस्क्ड, व्हाट डिड ही डू? ही टोल्ड, योर हॉनर, मैं राम भक्त हूं, राम जी की इच्छा से मैं अपना धंधा चला रहा था, राम जी की इच्छा से वो लोग चोरी करने के लिए गांव में आए, राम जी की जैसी इच्छा चोरी करके वापस लाते समय मुझे वो लोग देखने देखे, देखा कि मैं एक नादान आदमी हूं, तो राम जी की इच्छा मेरे सर पे एक ऐसे बंडल रख दी उन्होंने। राम जी की इच्छा, गांव से किसी ने पुलिस को खबर दिया था, पुलिस आने लगे, राम जी की इच्छा, बाकी सब चोर दौड़ के चले गए। मैं तो चोर नहीं था, मैं तो राम जी का भगत हूं, इसलिए मैं चल रहा था, मुझे पकड़ लिया पुलिसों ने, तो राम जी की इच्छा आके जेल में भर्ती कर दिया। योर हॉनर, राम जी की इच्छा यही है कि आपके सामने मैं जो खड़ा हूं, एंड जज कुड इजिली सेंस व्हाट वाज हैपनिंग, एंड इट ऑल सामान कहां है, चोरी का माल ये है, उसको रख दिया, रिलीज करो इसको इमीडिएटली, बाकी चोरों को ढूंढ के लिए आओ। योर हॉनर, राम जी की इच्छा से मैं मुक्त हो गया हूं अभी। व्हाट कैनॉट बी क्योर्ड मस्ट बी ओनली एंड्योर्ड। This is the brilliance of our philosophy. What cannot be cured can only be endured. Nothing can be done by shouting or making a mess or creating a lot of confusion. And sometimes when you endure, things get cured. Chai apne aap thanda ho jata hai. Jindagi mein bahut se samasya apne aap, they become cool and you don't have to work it out. So now with all these things, few things you will understand, that stress is internal, it is individual, it is not universal, in the sense that experience of stress is related to one particular individual only, and it is not existing in the thing or in the world, it is the way we relate to a thing. This being internal, to solve the problem, my attention must be focused on the problem itself. So the problem is your own inner instrument called heart or mind or the psyche. As you focus your attention and watch the psychological drama going on inside, the very observation will give you knowledge about how to manage it. And of the two methods, one is that you are the stress. And if I am the stress, nothing can be done. That comes with the knowledge. Secondly, stress is an experienced thing. So I am the experiencer and stress is the experienced thing. So experiencer is different from the experience. And this experience is not standing in my mind continuously for 24 hours. It vanishes even in the waking state. And absolutely it disappears during the sleep state. So it is not a permanent thing. The very knowledge that it is a permanent thing, even if it comes, will not disturb you. Like in the house, natkat bachche log aate jaate hain, pehle hum log gussa ho jaate hain, baad mein janne ke baad chhod do usko. And after some time, when you don't attend or try to control the mischievous boys, they will just watch and they become quiet. Third is, develop the art of meditation, that is the art of observing your own mind. And in the very observation, when the mind becomes quiet, you will get clarity, and from that clarity you act upon stress. The second last point was, nothing can be done with the stress, nothing has to be done to manage the stress, things have to be done to eliminate the stress. And that can be done only by acting on the situation outside where action is required. Act on that problem, once the problem goes away, you may have stress, may not have stress. Sometimes we have imaginary problems in the mind, is it not? And in actuality, there may not be any problem. Then adopt these three strategies of Indian approach. First, face the brute. If it is not possible, don't explode or break under the pressure of the stress. Pray to the Lord, oh Lord. In that very weeping, praying, sab laddu, peda, vada, mala, sab chada, it goes away, 50% of your attention is diverted. Thirdly, Sri Ramakrishna says, ye to Prabhu ki ichcha hai, jo hone wala tha, wo to hoga. Hum chahenge, to bhi hoga, nahi chahenge, to bhi hoga. Tsunami ko koi prime minister ne nahi bulaya. Is it not? So it comes and it goes. So the way, main point is how you attitude yourself with relate to stress. There was a lady in a village. She was rearing a wonderful mongoose because that area was infested with snakes. And daily she used to bring water from the nearby well, which was about 200 meters away. And she had given birth to a child 1 year before. So this mongoose she used to use as a watchdog. Whenever the husband will go to the office, she will be alone, the child will be there. So she will keep that mongoose there and go, so that nobody will trouble that child, because nobody else was there in the house. By that time, she goes and comes, it will be about 10 to 20 minutes, bringing a pitcher of water. So one day as she was bringing that pitcher full of water, suddenly she saw the mongoose standing near the entrance of her house with blood oozing out of his mouth. Simply she took the pitcher, hit the mongoose and killed the mongoose. Because the very scene, so much agitated. And just 1 minute, wait, you could have waited, na? And she ran. She thought that this mongoose whom I kept as a police or a watchman, as a guard, fellow has bitten my child and he must have killed it. She ran so fast, and when she went to see her child inside the room, she saw that the child was laughing and playing. There was a cobra cut into 7 to 8 pieces. Now what are they going to say? Where was the stress? In the mongoose? In the external world? Or inside our mind? What caused it? Lack of calm and quietness. Calm and quietness comes when you start observing the mind. Regularly practice this habit of meditation. We have the habit of getting agitated. That is one of the problem. Because we don't have that technique, by doing it, we have got a habit. Actions when repeated becomes habit. Habit when continued for a long time becomes your character. Character brings your destiny. How to make your destiny? Bhagya ka nirman. Change the habits. Habit is nothing but repeated action, na? We had one boy, he used to talk like this. Mai, aaj, cinema ko, jayega. So a lot of fun we used to have. So when he was interviewed, where is River London? River in Thames. So what is happening to you all? You cannot become an IAS officer. The answer is correct. So what he developed as a habit by repeated action for fun, it became a habit. Some of the people have a habit of going on, moving the legs, na, shaking the legs while talking. How it comes? It's a mechanical action. But before it became a mechanical action, it was a conscious action. In biology, it is called atavism. We can move our eyelashes. Cows can move their ears. We can't move. But Vivekananda says, every part of your body can be under your control. You have not used it. Similarly, you are the originator of your thoughts. As you start meditating, thought is your own creation, your own movie. You are the director and producer of your thought. But now you have lost the habit. You are thinking it is mechanically going. No. By practicing the control of mind, you can easily control the thought. Before the thought comes, you will become alert. So, rukja vampar. 144 laga vampar. Finished. Curfew, no thought can come inside. These are to be practiced, though it looks like a higher science. In India, yogis and rishis and saints have demonstrated it. Not only in India, even in the life of Napoleon, you can see. Once in the violent battlefield, Napoleon told, make a cordon. Nearly 150 soldiers made a round and Napoleon slept for 20 minutes. Told, I will just sleep for 20 minutes and again I will fight. So strong soldiers, they made a cordon and he slept. Napoleon had such control over his mind. He was another genius. Have you read the life of Napoleon? You have to see his life. Even all those great people, they have got some element of this control of the mind. Consciously do it, voluntarily learn it, and then slowly as you start applying, you will find, yes, it has got nothing to do with spirituality, or spirituality is a superstition. All these things vanish. So here, with best wishes to all of you, take life in your own hand. Make a Deshi brand solution, Patanjali. Just a Deshi mal banate, and you bring your own solution. Knowledge is inside you. We are thinking knowledge is in the books, is it not? Books contain information. Before it came into the book, it was in the brain of human beings. In fact, Vivekananda says, where was law of gravitation? Nobody knew it. When Newton was looking outside the window, seeing apple falling, the teacher shouted, "Isaac, look here." He asked teacher, "Why is the apple falling down instead of going towards the sky?" And she told, "It is out of our syllabus." Because he had never discovered that. And after that he went, focused his mind, found the answer. Vivekananda says, where was law of gravitation? Somebody told it was in the tree, it is in the ground. No, it was in the mind of Newton, he brought it out. Like butter in the curd, fire in the matchstick, knowledge is inside all of us. Apply yourself, and to apply that, you must have pressure. I wish all of you get this intense pressure so that you will rush to find a solution. Hari Om, thank all of you. If you are willing, I thought this discussion is more important. Okay, 10 minutes we will take. Afterwards, if there is time, question answer can be had. Already 1:45.
No problem. It's timeless.
Switch on this mic. Friends, gently relax yourself. Feel free. Sit straight. Keep your spine, neck, and head in a straight line. Be relaxed. As the sun rises in the morning and gets scattered all over the world, we too have got scattered through our actions and thoughts. But in the evening, when the sun is about to set, sun gathers all the rays into itself, becomes a red ball, and dips into the western horizon. Similarly, this is the holy time for meditation. Gather your attention and focus the attention on yourself. Feel that you are inside this body. Feel yourself from the top of your head to the tip of your toe. Your body is very strong, healthy, and relaxed. Your body is strong, healthy, and relaxed. Great sense of relaxation taking place inside you. You are relaxed. Watch the breathing process. Watch the breath going in and coming.
coming outside your body. Watch the flow of air going inside and coming outside as breath. As the breath goes out, feel that all the evil qualities like anger, jealousy, fear, selfishness, crookedness, and all the stress inside is leaving you and going out. As the breath goes out, feel that all the stress and negative qualities are leaving you and going out. As the breath goes in, feel that all the good and auspicious qualities like love, patience, courage, strength, unselfishness, sympathy, and great quietness and calmness entering and filling up inside you. As you breathe in, all the positive qualities and great quietness and calmness is filling up inside you. Positive qualities, energy, power, strength, and great quietness inside you. Great quietness inside you. Gently try to observe and feel thoughts, ideas coming and going inside your mind. Thoughts and ideas are floating through your mind. Clouds appear, stay for some time, float and disappear in the sky. Similarly, ideas, thoughts are coming in your mind, floating, gently moving away and disappearing. Just watch them. Do not accept the thoughts, nor you reject them. Simply watch, just as you watch the waters in the river flow. You stand on the banks of a river and the water flows. You just watch. Same way, just feel and watch thoughts, ideas coming and going. Let them go. Disappearing from your mind, your mind is becoming very calm and quiet. Your body is quiet, the breath flowing quietly and rhythmically. Your mind also is very quiet and calm. Great silence inside you. Great silence, quietness inside you. Great quietness and silence outside you. Silence above, silence below, silence everywhere, indescribable silence, expanding silence, great silence inside you. In that great quietness, listen to the message of Swami Vivekananda. You are infinite. You have unlimited power, energy, and strength inside you. You are full of courage, love, and sympathy for others. You are pure. All power is inside you. You can do anything and everything. History of the world is the history of few men who had faith in themselves. This faith calls forth the infinite power lurking inside you. Believe yourself. Faith is what is wanted. Moment you are afraid, you are nobody. If you think you are weak, weak you become. If you think you are strong, strong you become. Fill yourself with ideas of strength day and night. Strength is life, weakness is death, constant misery and hell. Physical strength, mental strength, and spiritual strength is what is needed. Young Indians, gather strength. Strength is the only medicine for all the evils of the society and life. chant the mantra, you just listen to it intently. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu Ma Kaschit Dukkha Bhag Bhave. May everyone in this universe be happy. May everyone in this universe be free from disease and be healthy. May everyone see what is auspicious and good. May none be subject to misery. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om. Carry the sense of quietness, silence throughout the day by trying to remember it every 1 hour. Just recollect yourself. Focus your mind on your own self for a few seconds by uttering your name or telling myself, myself, or I am, I am. You come back to yourself. A great sense of relaxation and quietness will fill you when you become self-conscious. Try to hold on to the sense of self-consciousness, alertness, alertness always avoids accidents. That is a secret of stress management, the 4A. Alertness always avoids accident. Try to practice this sense of self-consciousness or being alert and aware for 5 seconds after every hour. Slowly and gently, as you go on doing it, it will percolate into your mind, into your heart, then into your whole being, and you will find that like dotted lines, every 1 hour you become quiet for 5 seconds. As this will persist, you will find the duration of the quietness expands. And as the quietness expands, you will find you have become the basis for intense action. At the same time, you are quiet. When a woman pours little amount of curd into the milk at night, she keeps it free from all disturbance. In quietness, in calm, in silence, the milk turns into curd. If you agitate or shake the curd vessel or the milk vessel, you will find the curd has not formed. Similarly, for intense, right and successful action, develop this base, this sense of quietness and calmness. Every 1 hour, you will find the key for success in the silence of meditation. Take 3 long deep breaths, and with that, we fulfill this session for guided meditation. good wishes to all of you. May auspicious, good and successful thing come to all of you. Hari Om. Youngsters used to go to the forest where rishis, munis and sannyasins will be there. They will put this question to them. Sometimes it used to go for 3 hours, 4 hours. Sometime days together they will discuss. What do you call as brainstorming session? This I gave you in a very short and in a very fast way. Try to feel every step very slowly, you will find the whole nerves will be soothed, the system will become calm and quiet, and the lingering effect of this quietness will pervade the other working hours of your life. Like the background music, this will continue, and after some time you will find that it is occupying the total disk space of your mind, and from that calm and quietness, it is easy for you to take steps. Another 5-10 minutes you can allot for question answers. Do not feel any hesitation or shyness. When is the lunch?
Questions. The science people always say we don't believe in God. So what do we do then about the prayer?
We need not believe in God. We are believing in certain system when it works. Because if you condition yourself or restrict yourself by telling I don't believe in God, you believe so many other things which are not God. And first of all, what is the proof that science itself is totally correct? Somebody says and we accept. So there is no clash of science or belief. Spirituality is a super science. When scientists will come to that stage, they may accept. But in our India, they have crossed the frontiers of science and they have entered into the super science, which is called Adhyatma Vidya Sarva Vidya Pratishtita. It is a science of the scientist.
Yes.
Not the science of the external world. You have to read the famous book by the Nobel Prize winner, Fridtjof Capra, The Tao of Physics. I don't know anyone of you read that. Where he says the Western science is slowly merging into Indian metaphysics. Here we study the objective world, the next step of the science is to study the very scientist himself. Because without the scientist, knowledge cannot come. Knowledge has got two counterparts. One is the objective world about which the scientist is studying, and the science who is bringing out that knowledge. How his brain, how his mind and the whole system reacts. It's a total whole.
Beautiful. Anyone else? These youngsters must be congratulated. They have sat still.
She had one question, but I didn't answer at that time.
Who's that, Ruchira?
When he was asking.
Anyone else? This has been so illuminating, Swamiji. I have no words. Really, thank you from the bottom of my heart on behalf of all the students as well. But I now request Amruta to propose a formal vote of thanks.
Lots of books are available in the Ramakrishna Mission Khar Road. Gather the information, absorb it and then apply it. Beautiful ideas are there. Just as we apply the business ideas, management principles, go read them afterwards, make it your own and apply. And apply it in your own style, you will get success. There is nothing wrong in accepting the ideas. Thank you. Good wishes to all of you. I should appreciate, this is the modern India emerging from our land. And with all the fashion, not one of you are feeling shy about the spirituality. India is a land of spirituality which attracted all the invaders. So great things are there in India. Vivekananda dreamt and had a vision of great India. He says all these people, Indians, were rishis once upon a time. Again they are going to become rishis. Rishi means super scientist.
not scientist. So to our Anjali madam, with all great care and motherly love and affection for all of you, she has arranged this. And the theme of your club, mindfulness, today it was not the subject. Otherwise, that is another deep subject which is very essential for students and for everybody, to be mindful of every action. Otherwise, we are doing everything unconsciously. That is one of the causes for stress. Try to get into these subjects, go through it and learn it and apply it. And age is not a bar for knowledge. So thanks and hearty feelings to her, to all the students who so gladly took part, arranged all the things, they arranged the table, this thing, that thing and everything. So we have to appreciate, you see. Inside everyone there is something wonderful and great. So I heartily wish you all the success, wonderful future and great things to come for you, so that India will raise up again. Hari Om.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, sir. We on our part would also like to thank you for taking out time from your busy schedule just to give us a discourse so engaging, so humorous and so brilliant, delivered with such hair-raising oratorial skills. And I would also like to thank Dr. Bhilande, our convener, who arranged this session despite being ill, but she managed it today. And I would also like to thank the audience for listening with rapt attention, with eagerness and patience, and honoring our speaker today. So thank you for this session, and I wish you all a good day.